Hello everybody, welcome to episode 2 of Work Cuts. In this video, we will be discussing about Taylor series, something very specific to math and used in physics here and there. You might have heard about it mostly in math in your limits and derivatives chapter, wherein you are supposed to remember those series like sin x is this, cos x is that, e to the power x is this and that, okay? So it becomes too much, right? So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss one formula and you can derive all of the series that are there in your syllabus. Okay, so let's begin with our discussion on Taylor series. So if you had a hard time remembering those series, this lecture will be a bliss to you. Okay, so those who don't know what Taylor series is, it's actually, and loosely stating it, not going into the mathematical aspect, it's just a way of expressing a non-polynomial function into a polynomial function. Like we say, the Taylor series of sine x is this, x minus x to the power 3 upon 3 factorial. Okay, I'll tell you how this came, but yeah, we say this way, right? So we equate a non-polynomial function like a sine x to its polynomial expression, right? It's way easier to compute this. Suppose you wanted sine of 1 radian, like x, when x equals 1. So instead of going by trigonometry or graphical rules, you can just put 1 there, right? So you can use this expression now. 1 cube upon 3 factorial plus 1 to the power 7 upon 7 factorial. In other terms also, you don't have to take all of the terms till infinity. You can take finitely many, because this terms goes on decreasing. And you can only take this and approximate it, right? It's a good approximation. So Taylor series is x approximation. That is what I mean, okay? So that was a basic loose statement for Taylor series, okay? So the formula first for Taylor series is, so the first one you are not supposed to by heart. I'll tell you which one you are supposed to by heart. Suppose f of x, any function, non-polynomial or polynomial, okay? So you can express it as f of a plus x minus a into f dash of a. Now what is this f dash of a? First derivative, okay, y1 or y dash, whatever you call it. So this is the first derivative. Actually, a is a point, about which you are asked to find the Taylor series. It's a specific point, okay? So yeah, in our case it will be zero. Let's complete the formula first and then discuss things, okay? F double dash of a, now you can note that pattern, right? X minus a the whole cube upon 3 factorial into f triple dash of a or y3 or y triple dash, okay? And that goes on, okay? I'll write one more term, upon 4 factorial into f 4 dash of a, okay? So that goes on. But this is what we are not supposed to remember. We are supposed to remember the Maclaurin series. Okay, not adding words. We are supposed to remember the series when a is equal to 0. In our syllables case, this a is 0. Okay, this a is 0. And we derive the Taylor series according to this. Actually, it's Maclaurin series, but yeah. So the formula that we are supposed to remember is this. And using this, we can derive anything, okay? So f of 0, in place of a, put 0, okay? x minus a, so x minus 0, x into f dash of 0, right? Plus x minus, again, x minus a, so x minus 0, the whole square upon 2 factorial into f double dash of a, okay? And I'll write the third term as well. X cube, so x minus 0 upon 3 factorial into f triple dash of a, okay? This goes on, okay? Now you note this down. It's actually Maclaurin series. It's called Maclaurin series, and using this we are going to derive each and every one of the series that are there in your syllables under 30 to 60 second, okay? This is something which is general, like you won't have it in your syllables, but yeah, if somebody asks you for Taylor series about a point, generally the series which are not there in your syllables, then you can use this. But the important one today is this one, okay? You can note that now. This is 0, okay? Sorry for that. This is 0, and this is 0. You can note that down. This is the summary for today's class. You can take a screenshot as well. Okay, so I've put up the formula there. We'll try to find out each of the series. Let's begin with the first one. Let's say sine x. Okay, we'll take f of x equals sine x. What do we have to do? We have to just find these values, right? F of 0, f dash of 0, and f double dash of 0, and find a pattern. Okay, so we are going to find these values, find a pattern among them. Let's do it instead of saying it. So f of 0, the first thing we are finding sine of 0, right? Plug in a 0 at x. So sine of 0 is 0. Now find f dash of x first and then plug in a 0. F dash of x will be, what is derivative of sine x? Cos x. Now put a 0, f dash of 0. What will be that? Cos 0, which is 1. Now f double dash of x, again differentiate this, you'll get minus sine x, right? Now again plug in a 0. We are going to do this until we note a pattern, okay? Again a 0, right? F triple dash of x, that gives us minus sine x is cos x, and that minus sign still remains. So again plug in a 0, so we are going to see a pattern. Can you see the pattern? 0, 1, 0, minus 1. 0, 1, 0, minus 1. If you are not convinced, let's go for the first term, fourth term, sorry. And you'll again get 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, right? You should get a 0. Let's see that. So minus cos x, differentiation will be sin x. This will be minus sin x, and that minus sign will go. Okay, so y 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 equals. Okay, plug in a 0, sine of 0, 0, right? So the pattern basically is 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, okay? So that pattern, and we are going to plug these values over here, so we will get the series of sine x, right? We will get the series of sine x. So in place of f of x, we have sine x. Now just plug in the values, f of 0 is 0 plus x, x into 0, 1, x square by 2 factorial 0, 1, 0, minus 1. Okay, let's minus 1. Okay, again 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0 again. Again, you'll have 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1. Again, you'll have 1. So that goes on, right? So no need of writing that. Okay. That goes on. So you can simplify the series somewhere. Let's simplify it here, sine x. Let's not write this 0, 0 is everywhere. So we'll have x, this term is 0, this term is 0. This is x cube divided by 3 factorial. This is plus x to the power 5 divided by 5 factorial. And you can note the pattern now, right? So this is how actually you by heart the series. Okay, if you didn't know the formula, right? You say sine x, only odd terms will appear, alternate plus minus, right? Odd terms, odd factorials, plus minus, alternate plus minus, plus minus plus, and this should be minus. Okay, so don't by heart, you can derive it, right, within 30 seconds. Now I am explaining, so it's taking me time. Let's go for the second one now. Okay, each one in your syllables can be derived using this method. Okay, second one, let's choose cos x. Okay, let's choose cos x as f of x. Okay, let's go for it. F of 0, the first thing we need to calculate. So cos of 0, 1, f dash of x, find f dash of x, cos of x is minus sine x. Okay, so f dash of x, plug in a 0, so that will give us sine of 0, 0. F double dash of x, derivative of sine x will be cos x, and that minus sign is still there. Again plug in a 0 there, f double dash of 0, that gives us minus 1, right? Cos 0 is 1, and that minus sign. Okay, f triple dash of x, now this will give us cos x is minus sine x, and minus minus will make it positive. Okay, so sine x, now triple dash, put a 0, plug in a 0, so sine of 0, 0. So now you can get the pattern 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 0. Okay, so we got the pattern. Let's go for the series. It's easy now. Okay, so cos x equals इट विल बी 1 + x 1 0 माइनस 1 0 अगेन, सो अगेन 1. ओके, यू कैन गो ऑन एंड ऑन. सो 1 0 - 1 0 1 0 - 1 0, लेट्स सिंप्लीफाई इट. ओके ओके, सो वी हैव 1 माइनस x स्क्वायर बाय 2 फैक्टोरियल प्लस x टू द पावर 4 बाय 4 फैक्टोरियल एंड सो ऑन, राइट. ओके, सो हाउ डू यू बाय हार्ट इट? इफ यू had to by heart, it was like only the even powers come with the even factorials at the bottom in the denominator and alternate plus minus, right? Plus minus plus minus. Okay, so that is how you by heart, but don't by heart, we have the formula. Okay, let's go for the third one. Let's just have a rapid fire of this. Okay, third one, we'll choose a very simple one, which I should have chosen as the first one actually. So e to the power x, okay, e to the power x. So first thing, f of 0, okay, f of 0, e to the power 0, anything to power 0 is 1. By the way, what is 0 to the power 0? Okay, tell me that in the comment section. Anyways, let's continue. F dash of x, what is the derivative of e to the power x? E to the power x, right? So it is not going to change. So you'll get 1, 1, 1, 1 everywhere, right? F double dash of x, e to the power x, f double dash, again you plug in a 0 there, you'll get 1, e to the power 0, 1. Okay, so why am I repeating this? Just for fun. Okay, so 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, that is the pattern. So just plug in the values, okay? Excuse me. Okay, so you plug in the values, f of 0 is 1, then you have x into 1 plus x square by 2 factorial into 1 plus x cube by 3 factorial into 1, and that goes on, right? So this is the easiest among all of them. Okay, you don't need to write this one. So this is the series, Taylor series of e to the power x. Okay, this is how it looks like. Okay, it has both, right? Even, odd, both the terms. Okay, so let's go to a bit difficult one. Not that difficult, can be done by this formula too. Okay, so the fourth one, let's choose ln natural log 1 plus x. So find this Taylor series of this one. Okay, first job, what do we have to do first? f of 0, so plug in a 0 here. So ln of 1, so log to any base 1 is basically, log to any base 1 is 0. Okay, log to any base 1 is 0. Remember that if you didn't knew it. Okay, f of f dash of x, so find its derivative. What is the derivative of ln of x? 1 by x, right? So what will be the derivative of this? 1 over 1 plus x. Okay, so that is the derivative. Now plug in a 0 in the derivative. So we get a 1. Okay, that's an easy job. Again, let's find the derivative of this. So you'll have how to find the derivative of this. You watch it this way, right? So n, it's somewhat like x to the power n, right? So you can use that formula, n x to the power n minus 1. So after doing that, you'll get this. Okay, it's basic differentiation, no rocket science. Okay, again plug in a 0 now. So plug in a 0, you'll get minus 1. Pattern can't be seen though. Okay, we cannot see any pattern over here. Now when you now look at this way, the power minus 2, and you have minus 1 over here. So yeah, it will give us 2 upon 1 plus x to the power whole, x to the power 1 plus x to the power 3, and again plug in a 0, so that will give us 2. So now pattern cannot be seen. Let's compute one more term and we'll plug in the values. Okay, let's compute one more term and we'll put in the values. So f, how much dash? 4 dash, right? So y4, I'll say directly, not to confuse, right? Fourth derivative. Okay, so how will you get that? It will be 2 into 1 plus x to the power x, 1 plus x whole power 3, so minus 3, right? So this minus 3 will come down, and 1 plus x whole to the power minus 4. Okay, so 2 into minus 3 upon 1 plus x to the power 4, I can see, right? So that is the fourth derivative. Again, plug in a 0. So what do you get? 1, 2, 3, 4. Plug in a 0. Plug in a 0. So denominator is 1 and numerator gives you minus 6. Okay? So this looks quite random, right? We cannot find a pattern. So once you plug in, you'll find a pattern. Okay? Once you plug in, you'll find a pattern. Okay, you could have done more terms as well. You could have computed more terms. Okay, so the pattern is not visible anyways. Okay, once you plug in, you'll get it. So let's plug in the values. First one is 0 plus x into 1 plus x square by 2 factorial into, what is that, into minus 1 plus x cube by 3 factorial into 2, okay, plus x to the power 4 upon 4 factorial into minus 6, okay, and that goes on, of course. And now you can note it, okay, now you can see the pattern. Just you need to simplify a bit those factorial signs. Now 2 factorial, if you see, it's 2 into 1, right? What change does it make? 2 into 1 is 2, right? So instead of writing that factorial, I'm avoiding it, okay, I'm just writing 2. Okay, you'll get the reason why. And this is minus, right? Minus 1. So yeah, this is minus. Now the next term is 3 factorial. You have something like this, right? 2 upon 3 factorial, and that x cubed term. How can you simplify this 3 factorial? 3 factorial can be simplified as 3 into 2 into 1, and this 2 and this 2 can get cancelled, right? So what are you left with? That 1 by 3, right? Just 1 by 3. And okay, so we have simplified this x cubed by 3. So can you note that the factorial terms are going? So the factorial is getting dropped at every term. Next term also you can see that. So you have minus 6, okay, that minus sign will take outside, okay, and 6 upon, what do you have? 4 factorials, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So 3 twos are 6, right? 3 twos are 6, and you are left with 4. So that is what I'm saying. So now the pattern is visible, right? So you don't have factorials at the bottom. So if you want to by heart this, you can, but you know the derivation, right? How to derive it under second. Okay, so this is a very useful formula, I'll say. Okay, there is no more. Actually, there is one about 10x, which I will give you as a homework, okay? Okay, your homework is to find out the series of 10 of x. Take 10 of x as f of x and find the series. Comment down the coefficient of x to the power 5. Okay, when you do this, you'll find that the series of 10x is completely random. You don't have any pattern in that. So Taylor series is not always the language of patterns. Okay, you can have random things going on. So comment down the coefficient of x to the power 5 in your 10x series, and if you give me the correct answer, you'll get a heart from me, of course. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you soon in the next episode of Work Cuts. Till then, keep enjoying physics.